Does upward mobility on the social hierarchy change a person? And is this change for the better? Find out how you can maintain your humble baseline, even if you find yourself in a position of riches and power. Coming at you right now on Charles Hurst Reinvention. Have you ever known someone who you once considered a friend and a really good person, and suddenly they just seemed to change, drift away? And did this happen because suddenly they advanced hugely in their life financially? It happens. Two people were friends for years, maybe even decades. Then suddenly one person comes into money. Maybe that book they were writing goes viral. Or they got that high-powered master's degree. They were a pretty good person a few years ago, but now that they're a CEO, they're really not. All the adages do say that money will change somebody. But why? You still sleep horizontal in that bed you have in your better house. You still put your foot on the gas pedal the exact same way, whether you're driving a Junker or a BMW. As the saying goes, you don't put on your pants differently just because you own designer jeans. But yet, when people advance financially, they do change, don't they? They hang around new people who are now in their own financial status. Their values and philosophies of the world alter. And 10 years later, there's someone you don't even recognize. There are many things in this world that will make you a bad person. And one of them is the proverbial sin of pride. As the nuns in my old Catholic school would have stated. When I say this, I'm not talking about being proud of yourself. I was pretty proud that I got into physical therapy school, especially when the average that got in was about a 3.8, and I was a guy who wasn't incredibly book smart in the arts of physics and chemistry. And I have made something of myself and stocked a bit of money away. But what the diocese of my old Catholic school church would be talking about would not be being proud of yourself for whatever accomplishment you achieved, but thinking that accomplishment makes you better than others. Now, most people will give lip service when they state that they don't believe they're better than others, but I've always found it's the subtleties in their actions that you can tell where their mindset really lies. And it is something that we are programmed into. For every single society since the dawn of man has had social stratifications. Probably going back to the days of Bob and Bill in the caves. Bob and Bill used to be good friends, right up until Bob went off and found a much better cave, in which suddenly Bill wasn't thought much of, as he did have that messy trickling stream running through the middle of his domain. As the world developed, the word peasant was developed with it. The underclass. Those who were invisible when you walked past them. And it has always been incredible to me that a species who is only on Earth for a few decades thinks themselves so significant regardless of their achievements that they would consider someone else invisible at all. But this is how we operate. And most people will tell me again that they don't think this way. However, there is a very simple litmus test you can use on yourself to determine deep down if you do have that superiority complex. Are you a medical provider at the local hospital? Then next time you're at a restaurant and see the housekeeper there, ask her if she wants to join you. Would that make you feel uncomfortable? Wondering what other people around you would think? Well, there's your answer whether you have overcome this social programming or not. Do you see my point? Regardless of your background or belief, most people believe that there are many forces in this world that are constantly trying to take a good person and turn them into a bad one. And one of the easiest ways for that to happen is when you achieve a level of advancement, it is suddenly matched by a mental upgrade of you thinking you're better than those who didn't. One of the best ways to keep that mental mindset in check is to keep that mental mindset in a state of humbleness. They teach this in martial arts. Sure, when you reach a black belt level, you can beat on a white belt pretty easily. And a fifth degree black belt could beat on you pretty easily. And you have to condition yourself to treat that white belt with the same respect that you would want the fifth degree to treat you at all times. And the same goes for the work environment and when you walk past that homeless person on the street corner. I'm not saying you have to give away your money to the homeless person. I'm saying you don't walk past him like he doesn't exist. Because regardless of the reason he's there, he's still your brother. And if you want to keep yourself in that state of humbleness, you have to look at your fellow man as your brothers and sisters. When you reach a place of high advancement, as I've said before, you've been given a lot, so you owe a lot. You owe trying to make others' lives better around you by teaching them to become the best versions of themselves. And even if they won't advance their lives because of their own poor choices, you should still, at the very least, try to make them feel significant, like they can sit with you at that restaurant. I don't practice physical therapy much anymore, but the little bit I do today, I have and always have had a standing rule that when somebody comes into my clinic, they get to feel like they matter for 45 minutes to an hour. And we do have homeless people who come in off the street to make their appointments, because homeless people get hurt too. One of the saddest things I've ever heard in my life was a homeless person who was late for her appointment come in and tell me that she knew she didn't matter anyway. And that's the type of pain you have to try to alleviate when you are in that position of higher standing. You have to try to make things better for everyone who's not as fortunate as you, no matter what level you're at. That's something that I instruct to interns, that you walk through the hospital understanding that the CEO is no better than you, and you're no better than the housekeeper. And if you can maintain that mindset while understanding that finances are finances, but basically, human beings are pretty much the same, and then treat people according to this mindset, that will keep you from ever metamorphosizing into that bad person that I spoke of earlier. When you are in that position of high standing and fortune, you are not simply just to sit back and enjoy it. It is up to you even more so, through all your daily activities, to try to better your fellow man further. Simply put, the higher on the social stratification you are, should inversely match how much you focus on it. And by keeping this mentality, you will not only stay on the path of greatness for yourself, but you will provide other directional trail signs for others to find it as well. I'm Charles Hurst, author of The Shepherd and the Running Wolf, Path to Forgiveness on the Pacific Crest Trail. That and other works are found on Amazon. See the link in the video description below. I don't ask for donations. You buy one of my books for a couple bucks, then you'll get something of great value in return, for that is the capitalistic way. If you're ready to join our tribe of excellence, hit that subscribe, tap the like, and smash the bell, and I will see you at the next sunrise.